The Christian today is often discouraged and often condemned by pastors, by servants of God, telling them that they are cursed, often because they haven't brought their tithe into the house of God.
Se trouve dans Malachi, dans l'Ancien Testament, le dernier prophète.
And we find that in the Old Testament, in Malachi, the last prophet in the Old Testament before the coming of Jesus. And many use, they use this text to declare that there are curses upon all those who do not bring their tithe into the church. We have already spoken about how tithing is a heresy. And for those who don't believe it is a heresy, well, then they use the Old Testament to then curse Christians. They curse them. They declare that their life is cursed, and the poor Christian who doesn't have the revelation of the new covenant, the revelation of Christ and what Christ accomplished at the cross, they accept it, and the whole church accepts it. And many then live under condemnation, under accusations, and they carry these burdens throughout their life. It is very sad to see that this is what's taking place in God's church. Christians being under curses. It is heresy. As if Christians can be under a curse for whatever reason. Where does this idea come from? What is the origin of this teaching? How is it that Christians live under this burden when servants of God and pastors speak to them and tell them that they are cursed because they did not do what they should have done, or because they have sinned, or whatever other reason? So where does this come from? Of course it comes from the Old Testament. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. We must understand this clearly. The law was nailed to the cross. And since the law no longer exists, we can no longer be condemned, nor can we be cursed. Because curses and condemnation can only come when we do not obey the law. But because the law has been removed, there is now no longer any curse. There is no accusation on the life of a Christian. So what does a Christian now need to do when he stumbles, or when he sins, or when he drifts away from the Lord? The Christian repents. They repent and they taste of God's forgiveness, and they continue. There is no curse involved. But sadly, there are Christians who feel condemned because pastors tell them that they are under the yoke of their parents or their ancestors who practiced witchcraft or did all kinds of abominable things. And so when they feel bad or when they have a problem, well, now it means that they need to delve back into their past. They need to see what that Christian's background is, whether their father was a sorcerer, or if the second generation had evil dealings with the enemy and was involved in all kinds of unhealthy, demonic things. But no, we can't do that. What happened when we were born again? We need to understand what happened. Being born again regenerates us. And when this happens, God's word tells us that we are delivered from the power of darkness and we are conveyed into the kingdom of his Son. And another thing, being born again, it's not a family affair. It's individual. Whatever tied me to my father or to my grandmother or to one of my ancestors, in one way or another, when I was an unbeliever and did not know Christ, I could definitely fall under the power of those things. But when I give my life to Christ and I experience what it is to be born again, there's a regeneration that takes place. My past is therefore buried. How is a Christian going to blossom if he is constantly reminded that his father was a sorcerer, or that his father dabbled in magic
Mais finalement, le chrétien,
finally, the Christian will end up living in his past.
Mais la nouvelle naissance,
but the born again experience severs us from the past and it takes us into the kingdom of God.